If you've been around on my channel for the past year or so, then you know that I've done a lot of mic reviews, some good and some not so good. Well, there's been one mic company that's been willing to consistently work with me and also consistently delivered high quality products. That company is Fifine. They've managed to do it again with their K690 microphone. It's a $90 microphone that's more or less a Blue Yeti competitor based on how similar they are. Again, this mic was sent to me to check out and review by Fifine themselves, but as always, these are my own opinions, so let's check it out. You know, we have to start with the build. It's an all-metal build that feels hefty and premium. On the front, we have the Fifine logo, and just note that this is a front address microphone, not a top address microphone, so you want to make sure that the Fifine logo points towards your mouth and not downwards, or else you're going to be using the mic wrong. Underneath the Fifine logo is a physical mute button with an LED that tells you red if you're muted or green if you're good to go. It's a nice little visual indicator telling you if your mic is picking up audio or if you're muted. And the physical button is nice in case you ever need to quickly run off and do something instead of navigating through software. You just have a physical button that you press and it'll turn off the mic. There's a volume knob on the front for the headphone jack underneath, which means yes, you can use this to monitor your game audio or even hear yourself back through the microphone. And using the physical volume knob, you can use that to adjust how loud or how low the volume is. On the back, there's two physical knobs. The one on top is the mic gain or sensitivity knob that tells you how sensitive the mic is at picking up surrounding noises around you. Underneath is the polar pattern knob, which determines what polar pattern you're going to use when picking up audio. Polar pattern is basically the different ways that the audio picks up microphone. On the left side, you have stereo, which is great for vocals or instrumentals and could be used for streaming. You could probably even use it more so for ASMR. This is what the mic sounds like in stereo setting. Now if I move to one side here, you'll start to hear me only in one side. Whereas if I move back to the other side, you'll only hear me on the other side. So that's what stereo is, left side and right side. Second, you have omnidirectional, which will pick up any noise surrounding the entire microphone. You generally don't want to use this if you're doing streaming or talking on Zoom. The only reason to use this is if you're intentionally choosing to use this. This is what the mic sounds like in omnidirectional. So my voice is traveling not only into the mic, but bouncing off the walls and coming back in and being picked up from the different sides of the mic itself. Third, you have cardioid, which is the best setting for picking up audio directly in front of the mic. So something for Discord, Zoom, or whatever else you're using, this would be the best setting. This is what the microphone sounds like with cardioid settings. So it only picks up audio from directly in front. So if I move over to one side, it starts to really just fade away and you can't really hear it as well. But that's what the cardioid mode is. Really good for streaming, podcasting, or having meetings. Lastly, there is bidirectional, which picks up audio from in front and directly behind the mic. This is great for if you're shooting or recording any sort of interviews. This is the bidirectional setting. So it's picking up audio from directly in front here, but it'll also pick up audio from directly behind. Not so much on the sides here, but just directly here. So if I were talking to someone and they were responding back to me from where you're at, they would talk and the audio would be picked up from this back mic here. You're seeing how this is the perfect Blue Yeti competitor, right? They basically have all the same features. The volume knob, the physical mute button, the headphone input, the polar patterns, and the build is actually very similar. And then at the bottom of the microphone, you have the mini USB port, the headphone jack that I previously mentioned, and a quarter inch screw hole that you can use with this quarter inch to half inch screw adapter, so you can mount it onto any mic arm like this one right in front of me here. This is a really good addition because basically if you don't want to use the legs that are included, you can just mount it onto any mic arm and just use that. And of course, it also comes with a 6-foot USB cable so you can plug it into your computer. This mic is simply plug and play. No additional drivers needed to install. All you need to do is plug it up. It's super easy to set up and just start using. Next, let's move on to the sound test. This is a sound test of the Fifine K690 microphone. It's currently set to cardioid polar pattern. Once again, it means that it's picking up audio only from directly in front of the mic. The gain is set to about 25% on the knob here. And the other mic that I was previously using is currently off to the side. I'm not using that one right now. just this one. How does this one sound? Personally, I think that the audio sounds fine. Granted, it's not Shure SM7B or audiophile, like spending $300, $400, $500 on a microphone quality level audio, but for $80, this doesn't sound bad at all. If you're someone who's really into mic specifications, I'm just gonna leave them up here so you can see them. But I would assume that if you're looking into the mic specs that much, you're probably an audiophile and not really looking at $80 microphones. And of course, if you could probably already tell, there's no pop filter, which means that the air from my mouth is directly hitting the microphone. So that's just a little small thing to note. So now I'm switching back to this main microphone. Of course, being a direct competitor to the Blue Yeti means that you get many of the same issues that the Blue Yeti has, such as the lack of shock absorption or shock mounting. This means that any vibrations from the desk or touching the hard metal frame of the microphone will travel up the mic into the capsule and be picked up from in there. One way to alleviate the desk vibrations from going into your mic is by putting a little towel underneath the mic legs. That way, if any vibrations come through the desk, it'll go in and get absorbed by the little towel instead of traveling straight into the mic. I think that Fifine's microphones are only getting better with each and every iteration that they're putting out there. If you're looking for better quality audio for your streams, Zoom calls, or even just chilling in Discord, then this is the mic to pick up. The high quality build, the ease of use, and the multitude of different options like the polar patterns make it a fantastic product for the price. Anyway, that's all that I have to say about the Fifine K690. Leave it down in the comments below what you think about it. Do you think that you're gonna go with the Blue Yeti still, or do you really like this product? Let me know down in the comments below. Like the video if you liked it, subscribe if you haven't, and I'll see you all in the next video. Peace.